China is a big country with a vast territory and a large population. With the rapid economic development, China has built countless infrastructure and industrial and civilian buildings. Highways and railway networks extend in all directions, and high-rise buildings and large exhibition halls can be seen everywhere. However, the sheer number of buildings alone is not enough for China to be called an infrastructure maniac. What really earned China this title is that China has built many world-famous engineering projects, such as the world's tallest bridge, Beipanjiang Bridge, the longest cross-sea bridge, Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macao Bridge, and the longest undersea tunnel, Qingdao Jiaozhou Bay Tunnel. These remarkable achievements have made the title infrastructure maniac so resounding around the world that even some American engineers lamented that China's rapid development in infrastructure projects ranks first in the world. However, in the process of infrastructure development in China, some difficult projects have also been encountered. On May 10th this year, China announced the completion of a world-class tunnel construction project, the Daxing Tunnel. In order to build this tunnel, China invested $320 million, during which a total of 80,000 people participated in the tunnel construction, and it took 10 years to complete the tunnel. For American engineers, this tunnel is undoubtedly a world-class project. However, if the US government is allowed to build it, it may take 3 years for approval and another 5 years for construction. In the end, it may not be completed for 30 years. So, how important is this tunnel to China? What difficulties did it face during the 10-year construction period? If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. In today's era of rapid technological development, infrastructure construction has become a key core for the development of countries around the world. But in this area, China is far ahead of many Western developed countries. As of 2023, the total operating mileage of China's railway network has exceeded 158,000 kilometers, of which the operating mileage of high-speed railways has reached an impressive 48,000 kilometers. Accounting for more than 77% of the total mileage of high-speed railways in the world, ranking first in the world. What is even more striking is that the regular operating speed of China's high-speed railways can easily reach 300 kilometers per hour, and the top speed of some lines even exceeds 420 kilometers per hour. This speed makes many developed countries around the world feel envious and shocked. Behind these achievements, we cannot do without the wisdom and dedication of Chinese railway engineers. Although China has established a large-scale, four vertical and four horizontal, high-speed rail network for China, which is nicknamed the infrastructure maniac by the outside world, the journey of high-speed rail construction is far from over. Nowadays, China has begun to move towards an eight vertical and eight horizontal, high-speed rail network and continues to expand and improve its railway system. Just recently, China announced the completion of one of the world's most difficult railway tunnel projects. But what you don't know is that 80,000 people worked on this railway tunnel and it took 10 years to complete. In fact, this railway tunnel is located in Sichuan Province, China, and is called the Daxing Tunnel. The Daxing Tunnel is 23 kilometers long and is the longest single-hole, double-track railway tunnel built in China. But this majestic project was started as early as 2008 and was constructed by China Railway Ruyun Qinglan Railway Group with an estimated investment of $320 million. However, due to the extremely complex terrain, many challenges were encountered during the construction of the Daxing Tunnel. In order to ensure the smooth progress of the project, the China Geological Survey team conducted geological surveys for 6 years and designed more than 10 different penetration plans for screening. After in-depth research and analysis, in September 2014, engineers successfully circumvented the impact of adverse geology on tunnel excavation and operation safety, and officially started the construction of the Daxing Tunnel. As far as I know, the altitude of the Daxing Tunnel is between 2,600 meters and 2,822 meters. The mountains it passes through are full of landslides, accumulated rocks and debris flows, and emergencies often occur during construction. In the early stages of construction, Chinese engineers encountered a huge challenge, large deformation of soft rock. The direction of the Daxing Tunnel is almost parallel to the Minjiang Fault Zone. The closest point is only 500 meters away. The underground tectonic stress is very huge. Under the action of this strong geostress, the surrounding rock is mainly composed of phyllite, slate, and sandstone, with varying hardness. In particular, phyllite becomes soft once it encounters water, which greatly affects the stability of the surrounding rock, causing the proportion of large deformation in the tunnel to be as high as 32.6%. At the same time, engineers also had to deal with a series of problems such as tunnel face collapse, mud gushing, and water inrush, which occurred more than 300 times in total. In addition, the construction process also experienced many geological disasters such as the Zhuzhegu 7.0 magnitude earthquake, landslides, and debris flows. These disasters once caused the excavation length in some construction areas to be less than 7 meters a year. As a result, the Daxing Tunnel was widely, it is considered to be one of the most difficult cross-mountain tunnels in China. The engineer responsible for the construction of the Daxing Tunnel revealed that during the entire construction process, China used a total of more than 80,000 people to participate in the construction of the tunnel. The construction team completed more than 8,000 meters of geological drilling and 30,000 meters of physical exploration, and the total length even exceeded the mileage of the tunnel itself. Due to the extreme complexity of the Daxing Tunnel, all materials used are specially made. In the most severely deformed section, the diameter of the anchor pipe reached an astonishing 51 millimeters, and the weight of the steel arch per meter was as high as 50 kilograms, which is 2.5 times that of ordinary tunnel materials. After decades of arduous construction, China finally announced the successful completion of the Daxing Tunnel on May 10, 2024. This achievement shocked American engineers. After all, for them, the geographical location and construction difficulty of the Daxing Tunnel are unimaginable challenges. An American engineer even commented on social media, "I can't imagine how the Chinese engineering team overcame many difficulties in the past 10 years to complete this world-class project. If it were the United States, it might have cost 30. It's difficult to complete the tunnel in a matter of years." But this also aroused my curiosity. Why did China spend 10 years building this 22-kilometer tunnel? It is understood that the railway where the Daxing Tunnel is located is an important passage connecting China's Sichuan Province and Qinghai Province, the Chengdu-Lanzhou Railway. This is China's Class 1 double-track railway. The main line is about 836 kilometers long and has a design speed of 200 kilometers per hour. There are 13 stations along the way, including 10 new station buildings. The opening of this railway will become a fast, green transportation and life rescue channel in northwest Sichuan, China, filling the gap where there is no railway in northwest Sichuan. By connecting with the existing Baoqing-Chengdu Railway, Xiching-Chengdu High-Speed Railway, and the Chengdu-Xining Railway under construction, this railway will build an important railway trunk line connecting the northwest and southwest. The Chengdu-Lanzhou Railway will coordinate the coordinated development of regional economy and society and achieve unity and progress in ethnic areas, which is of important strategic significance. It is worth mentioning that in addition to the Daxing Tunnel, China's Dazhushan Tunnel also went through 12 years of difficult construction before it was finally completed. The tunnel is located on the highest peak in the southwest of Yunnan Province. Although the total length is only 14.5 kilometers, It is located on the most risky section of the Dalirueli Railway, with the deepest point reaching 1,000 meters, making construction extremely difficult. It is understood that the engineering difficulty of the Dazhushan Tunnel is no less than that of the Dashing Tunnel, and its geological conditions are extremely complex. Its characteristics can be summarized as three highs and four actives, namely high geostress, high geothermal, high radioactivity, and frequent activities of karst forms such as fault fracture zones, karst and karst water, underground rivers, and caves. This tunnel passes through six fault fracture zones. It not only has to face the threats of karst water and underground rivers, but also complex geological forms such as caves. During the construction process, the Dazhushan Tunnel frequently encountered geological disasters such as water inrush, mud outburst, and surrounding rock instability. The tunnel must pass through a 3,210-meter-long section prone to water and mud inrush, with a maximum water inflow volume of up to 120,000 cubic meters per day. In addition, the tunnel also needs to pass through a 1.27-kilometer-long coal stratum, which contains a large amount of gas, which greatly increases the risk and difficulty of construction. During the construction process, the total amount of water seeped out of the Dazhushan Tunnel was nearly 200 million cubic meters, equivalent to the water volume of 15 West Lakes. In order to solve the water seepage problem, the construction team scrapped more than 100 water pumps. Faced with these challenges, engineers continued to work hard and repeatedly adjusted the construction plan to ensure the smooth construction of the tunnel. In the end, in order to ensure that the Dalirueli Railway could be fully connected, the construction period of the Dazhushan Tunnel was adjusted from the initially expected 5.5 years to 8 years, and finally extended to 12 years. A total of $3.5 billion was invested before it was opened to traffic. China's pace of development has never stopped, and infrastructure construction is one of the key factors driving economic growth. Therefore, in the past decade or so, China has invested hugely in infrastructure, totaling $1.65 trillion. Of course, in addition to capital investment, technological innovation is also equally important. In this regard, China now has the world's largest shield machine, Jinghua. The maximum excavation diameter of this shield machine reaches 16.07 meters, the overall length is 150 meters, and the total weight is as high as 4,300 tons. The design and construction of the Jinghua not only demonstrate China's strong strength in the fields of mechanical engineering and precision manufacturing, but also serve as a model of technological progress. With the continuous advancement of science and technology and the gradual recovery of the global economy, the infrastructure construction market is expected to continue to grow, thereby providing strong support for the economic development of countries around the world. To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.